What's going on, guys? Episode 18, 660.net. Right now, right here, you've tuned into a truly independent podcast. The way we stay independent, we stay unedited. We're able to say whatever the fuck we think about, including just shouting fuck from the rooftops, is our wonderful sponsors. We have two sponsors this week. ReadUSComics.com, the future of comic books just around the corner. And Atomic Comics, located at 895D Montauk Highway, Schuyler, New York, 11967. You can call Mac and Brianna right now and find out what you need to read. They'll mail it to you. It'll be awesome. Or if you're in Shirley, the Long Island area, come on by the store. It's awesome. Sometimes you'll see me there. I'll tell you what to buy. I'll sell you some of my shit. It'll be awesome. Guys, this episode, the music is by none other than No Doubt. I forgot how fucking good some of their music was. Right now, you're hearing Staring Problems. At the close of the show, we're going to hear Open the Gate, both available on iTunes. This week's episode, jam-packed. We talk Muppets, Forgetting Babies, comics. We talk about death, reality, and fiction. Punching ladies when it's cool to do it and when it's not. And we round it out with a little bit more cocaine talk. Guys, big episodes. Let's get right to it. 660.net. Party time. Excellent, guys. See you at the end of the show. You're fucking retarded. Hit me with another one, buddy.
ABC has ordered 9 new shows for the next fall season.
Oh, yes.
Including a revival of?
I don't know.
The Muppets.
Yeah. It's time to get this started. Muppet show tonight.
We're going to eat your asshole, Muppet show tonight.
I don't think that was the lyric.
We're going to finger your cunt. We're going to eat your asshole.
None of that's true.
We're going to come on your face digitally like Paris Hilton.
Wrong. Not true.
No?
Not true.
That's totally the song.
It's not the song even
come
a little.
Come on Fraggle Rock's face.
That's a different show. It's a different show. It's not the Fraggle. No, that's X-Files. It's also coming back.
Come on my face.
No, I
digitally.
I'm starting to think that you and Jen need to talk about something. You and the fiance need to have a little conversation about
oh,
how
no,
you
she's
and
dead.
Drake semen.
She's dead. I smacked her.
Was it because she wasn't as loud as the cat?
Well, she was going to remember the whole thing. She was going to stab me. I smacked her.
Again, these clips, when I put together the show, play out of orders.
Yeah, no.
So you doing a
that's
callback,
why I wanna,
it just makes my
that's why
job
I
wanna harder.
Confuse people.
It just makes my shit harder.
No,
I won't
leave
want
it the
them
way
to be
it
confused.
Is. Fine.
No, because that's not really how I assemble them.
It's
so
tough
you're just,
not to reference
just
things
being,
when
it's
they
not
just
that
happen.
Tough. I just feel like you'd just be good at podcasting, and then we wouldn't have these problems.
You thought I'd be press pass material?
I did.
I'm not.
Is also the
I'm
only
not, you were sorely is, mistaken.
Is all
sir.
You have to say about the Muppets coming back that the Muppets are coming back?
No, I have
okay.
an actual thing.
Good, because okay. we've burned a few minutes.
Awesome. So. That's how this works. Per THR, the new Muppet series comes to us from Big Bang Theory co-creator Bill Prady and Bob Kuschel. That's his new name.
You were homeschooled, and I can tell when you read. Because you sound like you're speaking with an accent that you don't have.
Third Rock from the Sun. They created
it's
Third
coming
Rock
back.
From
oh,
the
I
sun.
Thought you were saying it yeah. came back.
No.
We're still talking about no. the fucking Muppets?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's described as a contemporary documentary-style show that will explore the Muppets' personal lives and relationships, both at home and at work. So apparently, they're like...
So it's going to be like the movie?
I guess so.
That's fucking trippy.
That would be cool.
That's, I dig it. So it's
I
not going to be like
think
the
of it
old Muppet
way.
Show. They are changing
well, the
it.
Second movie wasn't really like that.
I didn't see the second movie because it looked real bad.
The second movie was actually really good.
Was it?
Yeah, Jen and
I thought
Tina
the second
Fey was
Muppet,
in it.
I thought the second Muppet
the first
movie,
one was great.
I love the first one. I thought the second one, the trailer looked like shit.
No,
so I didn't bother.
I thought it was really funny. But anyway.
Really?
Yeah. I lost my spot.
It doesn't matter. You're going to read it like you
both
are.
Both at home
person.
And at work, as well as romances, breakups, and achievements.
Ooh.
Disappointments, wants,
gonna
and
break
desire.
Up? Are they going to break up fucking Kermit and Miss Piggy? Is anyone else fucking other than Gonzo and
those
chickens?
I hope Kermit walks in on Gonzo fucking Miss Piggy, but with that giant nose.
He only
and upside down because it points down.
He only fucks chickens.
That's weird.
Gonzo's a chicken fucker.
No, but he wants to, you know, expand his farm fetish.
I don't know why I think it's fucked up that he fucks chickens. I think it's just because they don't have personalities. like the chickens on the Muppets were just chickens.
They just cluck, yeah.
Whereas like Miss Piggy is like a
you got
humanoid.
Like the eagle, you got the frog, you got the pig. Yeah, but then you got Bleaker, who's not really anything.
Beaker.
I thought it was Bleaker.
No, it's Beaker because he's a scientist. Like a beaker in a lab.
Isn't a Bleaker or something?
It's not Bleaker, it's Beaker. You thought for fucking almost 30 years, yeah. You dumb fuck.
I thought it was Bleaker.
You thought his name was Bleaker. What's a Bleaker?
I don't know. Something.
I hate you so much.
No, they're Muppets.
Are you
what the fuck
kidding?
Is a Gonzo?
It's a fucking alien. It makes sense that his name
chicken?
Is fucked up.
Why are we arguing about
I don't
pets?
Know. Why didn't you just know? Did anyone on Periscope not know that Beaker's name was fucking Beaker? It's Beaker, like the thing. And he looks like a Beaker a little bit.
What about the Honduras chef?
The Honduras chef?
Yeah.
I hate your guts, and I hope your fucking fiance cheats on you with an alien. That's what I legitimately hope.
So it's going to go through breakups, achievements, disappointments, wants, and desires.
Wants?
A more adult Muppet show.
An adult
for
take
kids
on the Muppets?
Of all ages. There are also other shows you can look up that are in development out of... There's other shows in development,
oh God, you're like
but
an illiterate person.
This, in my opinion, is the only show one is to care about.
Did you write that, or did you copy that from someone else's article, and now you just write their opinion as your own?
What? No, that I added.
The only one, that.
They listed all the other nine other fucking fuck-all shows.
You don't give a shit?
And I really don't give a shit, other than the Muppets.
Did you
the Muppets
the...
are coming back on ABC, and they're probably going to have it for a season and then cancel it because ABC hates me.
Did you see the trailer for... Did you see the trailer for Supergirl?
No.
Oh, it looks so good.
I saw your postings, and I'm like,
I don't know. It's definitely for...
I feel like the new bandwagon is superhero TV shows now,
I mean,
which
is
quite
upsetting. It's not a bandwagon. It's just making so much money, which rules. Supergirl's great, though, because it like very clearly is for girls. It's like a show for chicks. And except it's fucking Supergirl. I cannot fucking wait.
Okay.
That's my only opinion of it. It's awesome. And she was one of those girls that was involved in the Fappening, and she has taken some dick from her boyfriend.
She was part of the Fappening?
Yeah. Yep.
We might have
did
have
not
to
know
have
her
age.
Name before, but I know it now.
Do you though? You don't care about her name.
I do not care about her name. I've seen Supergirl's vagina.
Have you seen her butthole?
With a big old ding dong in it. The guy fucking her was like well endowed.
Really?
Yeah, I was like fucking.
I'm gonna have to look this up.
Nightwing was fucking taking her to town. In my head, it was Nightwing.
I was going to say, I don't think there's a Nightwing anything.
I took the pictures and I used
was it
Photoshop.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt?
I took some Photoshop and I made it. Joseph,
did
Joseph,
you add like...
Joseph. I just called him Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
Did you add like did you add like a blue Nightwing stripe down his dick?
No.
You're like,
on.
Yeah, it's Nightwing now.
I drew the shirt on. Skin tight. It was just he had no bottoms.
Instead of the
Kara
fucking... What those? The... Batons in his
head. What would happen if Supergirl came? You know how their fucking vagina like spasms?
Mm-hmm.
Tear his dick off.
Heck. Well, she would have to control herself.
That would be the best.
Because
last
Superman
thing.
Fucking one the only one he could technically fuck is Wonder Woman.
Not
he can't
true.
Fuck Lois
Superman
Lane
has had
because
years
he will
practice.
Blow out her spine.
No, he just doesn't come inside of her.
Oh, then why even
he
bother?
He comes in his hand and throws him up in the air like LeBron James.
But why even bother then having sex if he can't come inside? Pointless.
I mean, I'm Puerto Rican, so I never come inside.
You never come inside.
I am
you
very
have to worry
afraid
about
of having
nine
kids. Look at that.
You jinx.
Fucking stupid minds think similarly.
Similarities.
Oh, no. There it is again. He's gone.
He's
from,
thinking again.
He's gone from suck to blow. Inasmuch as before you suck, now you blow. Because you're not very good at podcasting.
I'm press pass
going
material.
Going to Comic-Con!
Comic-Con coverage, mediocre style.
Woo! We're so close to having a panel. No one will
go. Oh my God, next
no
year,
panel. No one
will
go.
They'll be like, who the fuck? We're just going to talk about
email,
everything.
Like, we're willing to do a panel. We don't think anyone will come. We want you to advertise
$400 for a photo and signature. Yeah.
I would do that.
I know you would. I'd be paying people to get my autograph, and you'd just be standing there, no line, $400.
$400, bro.
$400.
If you want me and Gerard, it's $405, and I give you $5. I'm like, no, not even split, bitch. I'm the celebrity. Fucking one live viewer in our Periscope. This cat knows what's up. They know what's up. Fuck you, Gerard.
Fine, fuck you.
Have you ever left anything in a store before? Like, you went to go pick up Pop-Tarts, and you're like, I left my fucking car keys in the Pop-Tart aisle.
Does purchasing something and then leaving the bag with said item there count?
Absolutely. All How'd right. you manage to not remember the bag?
Jen and I, a couple months ago, we went to get hot dogs, buns, and a whole bunch of shit. And yeah, you did. Of course, the main part, we left the fucking hot dogs after paying them. For him there.
You're like, we're eating bread. I'm not going back.
Bread and ketchup. Toast sounds it. Delicious.
Toast it.
Oh, of course.
We're both going to lose weight by eating just carbs. That's a thing.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute.
But yeah, no, I've done that. If that counts.
It does. Okay. Not that impressive, though.
Okay.
Not that impressive.
Leaving a cell phone or car keys in my store?
Not very impressive.
Okay.
This person takes the cake. California. A mom forgot her 5-month-old baby in a donut shop.
Obviously, those bear claws were.
I'm
more
fucking
important.
Saying, well, no, she didn't even leave with the bear claws. She learned that they didn't have a donut that she was looking for. So the woman and her fucking cousin, the least useful cousin ever, went to Golden Donuts in National City craving a specific kind of donut. The store didn't have it, so they kept on trucking. This time, Yum Yum Donuts was their destination in Spring Valley in pursuit of their ideal. I don't fucking know what. Bear claw.
It doesn't. Okay.
So, I know a few women who've had babies, and baby brain's a real thing. You're gonna make some mistakes.
It is. It's sad.
But you forgot your baby. What?
Charlie's reading it like he's trying. No, this can't say you forgot baby. They it must just, have misspelled keys.
I've reread this fucking thing 1,000 times, and it keeps saying baby to me.
And I printed it up. It's not changing.
And also, what type of donut? Was it a cronut? I almost justified for a cronut.
Where do you get your cronuts, though? Have you got the Dunkin' Donuts cronuts? They're
all right,
not,
listen, I'm not that poor.
Okay.
I'm pretty poor.
Have you had the cronuts from that guy that invented, quote-unquote, the
also
cronut
no.
in the city?
But there was
because those are fucking delicious.
There was a dope place in the city by the last Ring of Honor
yeah,
show I went
I,
to.
I have to
cronuts.
Tell this guy. It's not patented. Everyone's been doing it. It's just that you brought it to the city and was making it famous. I hate this guy, but it's so, so delicious. The cronut. But Dunkin' Donuts is horrible. Anyway.
Here's my question, though. I don't know if I'd buy the story. I think she left her baby on purpose. I bet the baby...
Trying to trade the
was
baby.
A dickhead.
I got a feeling the baby was black. Why not leave
dickhead?
The baby there? No one wants a black baby.
Wow.
Just kidding.
Woo! I hope your baby comes out fucking jet black and you don't have the heart to question it. I hope you're fucking like that.
He has my eyes.
The kid's 14. You're like,
but his dick is bigger than yours,
you're
and
like,
you're a grown adult.
Gerard Jr. Sup, man? He just talks like Apollo Creed. Come here, Junior. Nothing, man.
You know, Dad, you're always trying to keep me down, just like the man.
Doot, 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 doot. He comes out like fucking just an old
I'm
school.
Hanging out with my son wearing FUBU. We have matching FUBU.
You just become real ethnic. You're like, Gerard, are you wearing a do-rag? Be like, it gives my hair a nice wave. Be like, I don't think you're, never mind.
Just like you to tell us what not to do.
Gerard is my slave name. My name, Kunta Kente. Be like, what are you doing? Yeah, I don't think you're allowed to say that,
I'm
Gerard.
Bringing it back. Porch monkey for life.
Oh, Jesus. Send your hate mail to 660@gmail.com.
No, send it to cgrcast@gmail.com. Ryan Jesus. Still monitors it, I guess.
Does he? Done. Fucking go back in time.
Send it to Ryan Parisi.
Leaving at silentgenerosity.net.
Sucks.com.
Terrible. God, you just want to mouth kiss him, don't you? You can admit it. You want to mouth kiss Ryan Parisi.
I hate him so much. But it's all done with love.
Love, it's the love-hate-love thing. Sincerely, though, she left that baby on
purpose.
She
left the fucking baby.
She was
baby.
Like, this fucking baby keeps swarming and squirming, and all I want is a goddamn chocolate-dipped
three
cronut.
Meals a day. It's so nice.
I think they eat way more than that, right? I don't understand
babies.
They eat all the time.
It was how old?
6 months.
I thought, I heard 5 years old.
Five months left at the store.
See, that's kind of still in cute, adorable like stage. Like, how do you forget a cute, adorable babe? Oh, it was ugly. It had
ugly
oh,
baby.
Was it? No, I figured it out without being racist. Ginger baby.
Ooh. You know, to be fair, though, all little black babies are cute. It's the little white babies that come out fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
There are some ugly black kids.
I couldn't be
black
more,
babies are goddamn adorable.
I couldn't be more of a fan of black babies. I'm more of a fan of black babies than black kids you or and, Spanish babies. They come out looking better.
You and Father Lavencia from down
Not
the road.
Not in that way. They just
You're
look
like, oh, I just like the way they fucking don't talk. I love the
no,
way
I like
they
the way they do talk. There's more like pizzazz in what they say. They're like, da-da.
More
you know, like,
pizzazz,
oh,
you monster. You're a monster person.
What? That's unracist. That's as unracist as you can get with me right now.
You
white babies look disgusting.
They're fucking weird looking.
They look they look like aliens, at least with like ethnic, urban
a little,
looking
a little
babies.
Tinge? You want to put a little...
they just look like
I
they,
put
they
a
would
little
have
coffee in that cream, daddy.
They look like they'd have more fun, is what I'm saying.
They do. They definitely like to party more. That's a baby fact. Baby facts. Name three baby facts. Go.
Three baby
go,
facts.
Go.
They like to party. They ruin your life.
They ruin your life. Fact.
You'll never sleep.
Never sleep.
And they'll suck you dry until they're at least 35.
That's not a dick reference. That's a boob reference.
Oh.
And we try to. What was it? You just said that like you weren't sure.
Oh.
You're like, no, no.
Okay. No, no.
My baby facts. All right. And I'm going to try not to revisit. One, they have been proven to be a liability while getting a donut. And I don't respect them for that. One, they don't negotiate with terrorists because they don't know words. So that makes them shitty. They should not negotiate with terrorists because they're fucking American. That's right. Only American babies on this goddamn show. And number three, babies. When you put them in the little baby Bjorn, they shouldn't fucking kick around so much. They're kicking you in the tum-tum. That's rude.
Oh, my God. I just have a feeling. Just dawned on me. I might become a baby Bjorn dad.
Maybe. No, we're going to strap
that. I don't want that to happen.
We're going to strap it onto your back like it's fucking Yoda on Luke.
Oh, I want to get the little hat for him, too. Oh,
yeah.
Done. Done.
Fuck yeah. We'll have to give him a neck brace because you bounce around a lot.
It was so funny.
You're like a human Tigger.
I was thinking about all the funny things I could do, like especially if I have a son. I want to get a Donkey Kong red tie and get him a Diddy Kong red Nintendo hat. So it looks like Donkey and Diddy. Type of thing. I'm gonna do so many like father son pair offs.
You're gonna be the.
I'm gonna have 19
you're gonna
fucking
be
daughters
that
now.
You're gonna have that parent.
I'm gonna be that fucking dad. That's
you're gonna
like,
keep having kids until you have a boy.
Oh yeah.
30 kids later,
yeah.
You're like, I
yeah.
have no money.
Yeah. I don't care. I want a son. That's just like that's happening.
All right. Well, I'll tell Jen to.
And I might
up.
Name him John Rivera, cause so he has, you know, he can grow up to be good looking.
Huh.
Unlike.
Oh well. If
John
my,
Rivera Nolan.
If my depression wasn't bad enough. Thanks for that, Rabbit, you son of a bitch. What? I've lost my fucking mind. So some shit was going on from Kizza Music. K-H-I-Z-A Music is where I saw it. They may have reposted it. They may have made it. I really don't know. But it's a picture of a woman.
Okay.
It looks like scared. And the caption and the over it, it's like a meme picture, I guess. Not really, I guess. I don't know technically what a meme is, but I'm assuming
a meme,
this
a meme,
is it.
Whatever.
So it says, it doesn't matter what she did, it's never okay to hit a woman. Ever.
Here we go.
So I would like to take
first off,
I would like to take a couple minutes to list all.
It's
I,
always
I,
okay
I
to
would
hit
like,
a woman.
I would like to go back and forth times it's okay to hit a woman. I'll give one, then I want you to give one.
Okay.
I'll go with a layup. She asked me to spank her booty. That's hitting. I'm hitting her booty with my open palm as hopefully we make sweet, passionate love.
Okay.
A perfectly acceptable reason to hit a woman. Gerard?
When they ask you for a high five.
When they ask you for a high five.
After exceptional sex.
You're slapping hands.
Or, you know,
slapping
very,
hands.
Very mediocre sex, but not crying is involved.
Exactly right. She has drowned two of our three kids and is about to drown the third. I'm allowed to hit her because I want to save the third kid.
Yeah.
Gerard?
She's going to take out a knife to stab me.
Perfect. I'll take that one to
self-defense.
To its next logical step. She has currently stabbed me. I am going to punch that bitch.
Wait, so she was going
neck.
To stab me. I hit her. She then turned
her,
I hit her
swivel.
So I hit her so hard across
and
the face.
And actually stabbed
and
me.
And then what happened was she was going to stab me. I smacked her. And it was like a Three Stooges little spin around. Exactly. And as she was still moving forward with her arm, she stabbed you.
The centrifugal force caused her to stab me, and I just popped her in the mouth.
Yeah, you popped her in the mouth. She fell backwards, and we did a little trust fall.
Delightful.
And I held her.
Delightful. And you know what? Frankly, she admitted she was wrong. I got a couple stitches, and all was good. I believe it's your turn.
My turn now? God damn it. I put so much thought into that little Three Stooges little skit. Thank you. If she... no, I can't say if she cheated on me.
I got paid to fight Ronda Rousey in the UFC. Perfectly acceptable.
Perfectly okay.
To punch Ronda. Yes. Now, don't get me wrong. She just beat that woman in 3 seconds, so I would maybe last a second.
Yeah.
With that being said, I would still try to punch Ronda Rousey. I would be very erect the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Something very sexy about her when she's trying to be angry. Just love it. That scene in Ghostbusters where Dane is possessed by the demon and about to become the dog after having sex.
A car accident and she's hysterical, there's no way of calming her down. A little smack across the face to calm.
You went
do that
very
with anyone.
1970s. I'm not going to sign off on the smacking to calm her down, but I'll let you have it.
You accept it? Okay, good.
I am a criminal and I'm fighting Batgirl. In a movie or in reality.
Okay.
If I just feel like if superheroes started up, I couldn't really be a superhero.
I got
I'd
one.
Try to be a
If I am committing a crime and a female police officer comes to arrest me, self-defense. I don't want to be arrested.
I mean, I'm not 100% that counts. Again, I feel like you're... if I'm a doctor and I specifically am a doctor who catches the baby after...
Oh, so you smack
out,
the ass?
And I smack the feet. They smack the feet now. But
oh,
that's
really?
A perfectly acceptable reason.
Why don't they smack the ass anymore?
I think just because it's like kind of sexual.
Oh,
I don't wanna,
my God.
I don't
want
to. First of all,
nothing ever
first
sexual
of all,
about
I
that.
Made that up to try to be funny. So the fact that you're going
have
left
you,
with it.
Have you ever seen a baby's butt? It's the cutest thing in the world. It really is.
Well, we got a pederast on our file. And I feel like we're falling left of the point. we're having a mixed...
and those 14-year-old girls, man. You know what they say about those high
school
girls?
You have taken
girls?
My 14-year-old girl somewhere, and she told me that you smacked her on the ass.
Okay.
I'm going to punch you.
That's not acceptable.
So hard, you're
going
to fly
acceptable?
Back into your mother.
That's not
and
acceptable.
And that's going to count as hitting her.
I think it's totally acceptable.
I feel like there's a bunch of reasons. Can we please stop being so fucking broad with our statements?
Well, yeah, it's always the same. It's never okay to hit a woman. But
there are times. Sorry. Sorry, there are times.
Yeah.
My bad. I'm sad that you're sad that there's always times it's okay to hit a woman.
Yeah.
That my bad. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah.
There are a couple times. I also believe that all men should shake women at least twice a week because they just deserve it. Let's be honest. I've had a girl threatening to fight me for a week.
Yeah.
And it's going to happen.
We are
going to fight, woman.
I've gotten into really bad, maybe, I think, Jen and I have gotten into one really, 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 like, the fight, you know, the fight of fights.
It was almost a breakup fight.
Yeah, and to calm her down, I didn't shake her, I didn't hit her, nothing. I, put my arms around her and grabbed her and just held her, just like stop. And she was so loud, she said, get your hands off me. And that translated through the next room to her mother's room. She got up, came to the door.
I wouldn't have even asked.
And her father did, and they opened the door. And as soon as they opened the door, I just put up both of my hands, and I'm like, everything's okay. Everything's fine. And her mother, of course, says, well, I heard Jen say, don't hit me.
Yeah.
And Jen stood there and said, fuck you. I didn't say don't hit me.
Oh, God.
We were having a fight.
She was
Gerard
amped
put
up,
his,
huh?
She
goes to her mom. She's like, fuck you, cunt. I'm like, damn, Jen.
She's like, Gerard put his hands on me to calm me down. We're just arguing. And I say, and I look at both of them, and it was just one of the scariest moments, actually. And I say to them,
like, because if I was her dad, I'd have shot you.
Yeah, and I say to her dad, I'm like, I say to both of them, you know, I would never put my hands on her, like, to harm her. It was purely to calm her down. And her father looks at me, and he looks at her, and he's like, does she know that? And Jen says, yeah.
That's pretty intense.
And Jen's like, yeah. And he's like, good enough for me. And he goes in his room. You know,
I would have murdered
and I was I was upset for days. I went down the I slept in the basement. I wouldn't make eye contact with them. I wasn't at the house for a couple of days.
Man.
And when I saw
rightfully
them,
so that's a shitty, that's a tricky situation to be in.
Well, her father, you know, he says to me, he's like, "Is everything all right with you?" He's like, "You haven't been around." I was like, "Well, honestly, I feel like I can't be trusted." He's like, "No, don't feel like that." He's like, "You guys had a bad fight," and I told him, I was like, "You know, I respect you guys, and you know, you guys coming out of the room and looking at me, I expected that because it is your baby girl, and I don't want you to ever, 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 ever feel like I would do that, and especially under your roof, you know?"
I would have left out the especially under your roof part, because that implies, like, but the minute we get in the apartment, I am beating the
I said I would never, never do that to her in any other situation, but
no,
like,
no. Again, just specify. Like, I would never do that in front of you in your house on a Tuesday. That implies, like, Wednesday is hunting season.
Oh, yeah.
But at the end of the day, bitches, watch out. You need to remember.
But, like, I can just even me, like, trying to calm her down with just holding her is like fucking treacherous waters, you know? It just...
Well, that's because your dick was erect.
I was in my boxes. That was the other thing, because we were fighting at fucking 4 o'clock in the morning.
About what? What was the fight? How dumb was the fight?
I don't remember. I think she was drunk.
It was bad. Fucking vanilla ice cream is better than chocolate. Don't be ridiculous.
It was about something. It's so unimportant, I don't remember what it was.
Never swallow like that on mic again. It sounded like a fucking 3 gallons of cum were in your mouth. And you
Perez Hilton.
Down too.
That's all because of Perez Hilton.
Yeah, he drew some digital on you.
Yeah,
he was
and it was so good that I felt it, like physically.
Perfect.
Like he's that much of an artist.
He's such a talent.
He's a cum aficionado.
But again, here's the fact: never say never. I'm going Justin Bieber logic with hitting a woman.
Really?
You stab me, you murder my kid. Guess what's gonna happen?
You're getting
I'm
hit.
Fucking socking you one.
You burn the roast.
As I'm dying,
you're getting hit. You want to vote? You're getting hit. You're gonna burn your bra? Getting hit.
Huh. I once again feel like we went left, and I love when
you want to sit in the front of the bus, you're getting hit.
We've fallen off.
Off subject.
So, Don Draper, we've gone left. Gone left to mundo. So, I'm going to end the segment. Watch out, Gerard.
I love 24.
Such an asshole.
So, if you die in real life, you die, right?
I would hope so.
Okay. Okay, now that we got that.
I don't want to zombie this bitch.
Okay. If you die in, like, a video game, you come back, right?
Yes. Also
okay.
True.
Generally
speaking.
Yes. In Diablo 3, there was a game mode that if you die once with your character. Now, the way Diablo runs is you play through the first 4 acts. You get up to roughly around level 30 on the normal setting. And then after you complete the game, you can go back on the hard setting.
Okay.
And go through levels, like, let's say 31 or whatever, through 60, you know, your character level.
Yeah.
Okay. Then after you do level 60, then you can go back and do, I think it was Legendary or something, or Nightmare. I don't remember the names, but there was normal, there was basically easy, hard, and easy,
impossible.
Medium, really hard. The impossible one is ridiculous, which I'll never do, because now you have all these stats, you have all this crazy gear on your character. If you die once, your character, he could be a level 60, dead, gone, deleted. You don't have that character anymore.
That's awesome.
That's amazing. There's another game that's taking that to a whole new fucking level. If you die in this game, you can never play again.
What?
Ever.
What are you talking about?
Some games have permadeath, where death causes you to lose a character forever, such as Diablo 3 that I was just talking about. Obsidian Circuit, however, has permadeath. If you lose, you can never play the game ever again.
You're fucking kidding.
The fantasy RPG plops specially selected players onto a single server and divides them into 2 teams of 4. So 8 people are playing this game. This means only 8 players will ever be playing Obsidian Circuit, that's the name of the game, at any given moment. and their adventures
the fuck up
will likely come to swift, brutal ends. Sounds terrifying, right? Every move you can make, every move you make can literally be your last. On top of that, the game will have our participatory audience watching live, so you can watch these turns
people
of events happen,
kind of like
Twitch. Something nearly as cool as the one death ever conceit. However, here's how it works. Each contestant explores the overworld and generated dungeons in search of the Dream Tech crystals. So basically, it's one team against the other. You're trying to get these Dream Tech crystals. They fight monsters, avoid traps, and compete with the opposing team. When the contestant fights monsters or gets treasure, the EXP or experience and other rewards go to the audience. EXP is used collectively by the audience. It's fucking light. I can see right through it, so I can barely read it. Hold on. No, it's not that. It's the fucking sun. The sun's fucking with my poorly done article. By the audience to level up the contestant's skill tree. Simply put, the audience is part dungeon master, part strategist, and part judge and jury.
Jesus Christ.
Matt Murdock. Obsidian Circuit doesn't have a release date. This came from...
How much is that going to cost?
I don't know.
Do you hypothetically...
It could be a mobile game. It could be a fucking... I got a feeling it's going to be a free game on their website that you log into the server, because who the fuck...
How will they prevent you from just using a different server?
Sadly, there's only one server. There's only one... only eight people...
No, what I mean is, how will they prevent you from, like, using a different computer, I guess?
IP addresses.
That's a weird way out of
IP
it.
IP addresses? Because if I log into my computer from here, I have your IP address.
Oh, you can't.
Yeah, so... you know what? Honestly, Max, how much would you... Like, if you had to pay to play this game once, how much would you pay?
That's an experience.
You know, that to say that I tried the game that you could only play once.
I might pay $10.
I'm topping off at $10.
$9.99.
$9.99, $10.85 with tax. I'll pay that.
Whoa, I gotta pay tax? I don't want to play.
I'll pay once to play that, and just to say, hey man, I paid fucking $10, and I'll try and push it, man. Just think how nerve wracking that is. You're playing this game.
Ironically, not more nerve wracking than real life. Because real life, we're a moment away from a bear.
That, just think about it, though. I don't know.
How fucked up is it that there are just people watching? Be like, I hope this guy dies.
Right?
I hope you die.
I would watch a lot.
Die, Peter! Die!
But you know what? It should also come with a free webcam, so you can watch the as soon as they die, you get to watch their reaction, because it's one and only shot you got to play this fucking
game.
If
it is a mobile game,
yeah,
it should force the camera on. So you have to not only is it your face, but it's the least attractive you'll ever be.
The screen,
because the camera's up your dick.
The screenshot of it, it kind of looks like Diablo. Kind of has like that eagle eye, kind of at an angle view.
Gotcha.
So I got a feeling it's like a dungeon style, like point and click game. So it's got to be a computer game.
It looks like looks like the character design for Jack
and Daxter.
Daxter. Yeah,
that's
yeah.
funny. You're reading the thing that's right underneath.
I am. Way to blow up my spot.
but no, when I was looking, I was like, this kind of does look like fucking Jack and Daxter.
Jack and Diane.
Yeah, Jack and Diane.
Jack and Diane.
It was pretty, pretty interesting to hear about something like that. Cause I immediately said, "Fuck you, I'm not playing it." But now I'm like,
liar! You're like, take my money. Yeah.
More than $10, though. Fuck you. Thank you.
Except
no, thank you.
Also as well as yes, please. You love me. Don't you dare.
That
pretend.
Was so on the rape.
What?
Line.
What are you talking about?
When you talk about a wo- you basically imply like, oh, she's a wounded
imply-
gazelle. She
What's
can't
wrong
get away.
What I'm saying is some girls are easier to catch than others.
Especially the ones that literally can't get away.
Well, yeah. Or
where are you going? nowhere. You ain't fucking going anywhere.
No.
Zip.
All I was implying was for the same reason that you're engaged to Jen.
Okay.
Was because she was a wounded gazelle. Her last boyfriend was a fuck up. Yeah. You were able to slide in there with your tomfoolery and your tight pants, and she fell in love. Don't you dare imply when we were talking about hand angels a while back that me saying a fucking wounded
You know,
gazelle.
We were literally talking about hand angels in reality.
In reality,
2 seconds ago, but you're like, a while back, but the way you put your hand
I don't
out,
know how I'm going to edit it.
All right.
This could be fucking 2016's podcast. I don't know.
It could be.
I don't know your life. That was awesome. Hand angels. For anyone that doesn't remember, go listen back to that episode. I don't know where it is, but I'm going to make
it's
that
somewhere,
logo. Do
somewhere.
You have the logo?
I don't have the logo,
I
no.
need to find the logo or make it.
I'm
adding a dick. It's winding up on the cover of our website. Dick hand angel.
I'll forward that. I was for it when we talked about it. You know,
yeah.
A while ago.
Oh,
wink. Quotation
podcast.
Marks.
Wink.
Pod time.
They made a huge fucking deal about, I like Superman comics. I know it's not hip to say, but everyone who thinks like comics are hip at all are pretentious cum dumpsters. Guys,
everyone's
and girls,
into comic books now.
It's
everyone's
the
into
culture.
The fucking like superhero shit.
But
everywhere.
Superman, they're ending the new 52 label.
Mm.
Mainly because there's not going to be 52 books. The new solicitations are 49 books after.
So they couldn't even make it to 52.
Well, they don't want to. That was the problem with the new 52. Once they had that imprint,
mm-hmm.
that they were like, every month, 52 comics, you started getting a lot of shitty comics.
Yeah.
I don't need 92 Batman
books. So there was more quantity than quality, basically.
Correct.
Okay. They kind of overshot.
Totally.
Whatever.
All these hateful fucking nerds are celebrating the end of the new 52.
Oh, fuck
you. And I'm
like,
hey, asshole, the story's continuing. It's just after Convergence, things change. What everyone thought was going to happen mm-hmm. after Convergence was they were selling that Superman got a new costume. Superman's old costume, I actually think, while I didn't love it, and I still think the classic, personally, it's like a hybrid of the Keanu Reeves and the Lois and Clark New Adventures of Superman costumes.
Okay.
I like the big S. I like the boots with the pointed V.
Yeah.
Christopher Reeves were too high. Everything else on his perfect costume I thought was perfect.
Mm-hmm.
The S size and placement, the whole fucking nine, collarbone showing. The new costume, the new 52 version of the costume was supposed to be Kryptonian battle armor.
Mm-hmm.
So I really loved the concept. It was like, yeah, it makes sense. Like that his mom didn't make it. Well, there were certain things I hated about it. I hated the collar. I hated that the boots didn't have the point.
Mm-hmm.
I miss the briefs. Who don't? I don't mind the red belt because, again, a gold belt would look kind of fucking like pro wrestlery.
See, storyline-wise, I would have been okay with them just making it where the mother... She made his father's S, and she, like, made, like, as if it's a patch. She made that. Instead of the whole costume, like, at least have the mother be some part of it, because it's, that still holds some, like, sentimental value to missing
things.
His mother and father. Like, my mom made that S for him.
I love that his blanket is his cape.
Yeah.
So now I don't know how they did it because I know the Superman in the new 52, they did a couple cool things with when he first shows up as Superman. It's literally a T-shirt with a stitched on S and the cape is his baby blanket. That's why the S is black.
Right.
Then he gets the Kryptonian battle armor. I kind of think it's a cool idea. I didn't love the way they went about it. And I don't love that. Some people are like, why the fuck is he wearing armor? And I'm like, well, motherfuckers, he doesn't have a sewing kit.
Yeah.
The new version, I was kind of hoping it would be a Ma Kent sewn thing because it looks like fabric again. It's pretty cool, but everyone, when they saw solicitations for this issue, lost their mind. It's a solicitation for April's Action Comics, I think, and he's flying, and it looks like he has fingerless gloves on, and people lost their shit. The artist is just a weird artist. It's not. It's just a low-forming cuff.
Okay.
It's not gloves. It's like a turtleneck, though, which I hate again. For some reason, they insist everyone's superhero collar goes underneath their chin.
Yeah.
I fucking hate it. Like, let me just see his goddamn collarbones. But it's much the same. They didn't
change
the belt
much. I like
a deep
V on their, their torso.
Yeah, it's just I want to see. Like, I get why Batman doesn't have that, because Batman's mostly covered head to toe.
Yeah.
I even get why Aquaman has it in Green Lantern, but Superman's that guy. Especially with Wonder Woman having so much of her shoulders exposed, and it helps showcase, like, from an art perspective. It helps show off how fucking strong she is.
Yeah.
I feel I want Superman to have that same look.
See, I never other than what's his name in the last Superman movie,
Henry Cavill.
Yeah,
his is lower.
Yeah, his is a lot lower. Like, you almost see like chest hair. Like,
you do see chest hair, and I love it.
I really liked.
You want proof of how on the edge of a fucking homo I am? Yeah. It's how I got the vapors when Henry Cavill was topless.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, whoa.
Like, that was my, I want a, almost like
but
a
it's
rough,
not gay because he's an alien.
No. He doesn't have a dick. It's fine. I like more of a manly, rugged Superman. When we started playing,
that's
this
your
was
ideal
years
date?
Ago.
You're like,
yeah. When we saw, like, the really clean cut Superman, I'm not really a fan of. When we started playing DC Universe, when that
yes,
came out,
I love that
like
game.
4 or 5 years ago,
I missed that game.
The opening, they now added it to PS4, and it is dope.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it still free?
Yeah, it's free to play. All you gotta do is just buy fucking if you want like expansions or whatever, but it's cheap.
It's
a great game.
But, I have a sinking suspicion, and I might be totally off base, and this is happening way after my birthday that you'll hear this.
Mm-hmm.
I have a sinking suspicion. Wayne and my people got me an Xbox.
An Xbox One?
I think so.
Are you happy about that, though?
Oh, I'm happy about anything new, because I'm not buying myself either system.
I love how, like, they all know, like, I'm one of the closest people to you. They never include me. Like,
well,
I'm just saying it now. Like, they never say,
you
like...
And, they consider you and John.
Oh, like, we figure it out on our
friends.
Own?
Well, it's weird because
like they never like say, hey, by the way, we're doing a big gift for Charlie. Do you want to pitch in?
Well, no,
because
like,
honestly, that'd be a lot easier.
Let me
however,
also say this. Let
a
me...
lot less fun for me because I like doing
yeah.
it on
well,
my
let
own.
Let me also say this.
But fuck them for not including
the
me.
The group gifts are something I started a while back.
Yeah.
I arranged for Karen to get a new television.
Mm-hmm.
Group gift. I arranged for Wayne to get the $1 million title for his birthday last year. And I might be wrong, but you know when you get a vibe, I'm hoping I'm right, but that'll change shit because I have no brand loyalty.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of secretly hoping.
This That's is my new thing. Xbox.
So I might be disappointed.
You might be.
Also, I might not get anything.
Oh, it was a PS4. Damn
it. I would still be stoked about that. Yeah. I just want a new gaming system.
Yeah.
I won't lie, though. I think Wayne's company, one of my best friends, going to mention him a lot on the show, his company might be striking. So I like might not get any birthday gifts from him.
Yeah.
And I'm so used to getting a shit ton of birthday gifts from him. I might just cry a little. How the fuck were we talking about Superman?
We were talking about DC Universe, but that opening.
If I got a new system, I'm reinvigorating my video game playing. I'm like, nope, I'm investing. No more sleep.
Oh my god,
sleep's for fags.
You should. But the opening cinematic of the big battle and whatnot in that game, he was hibernating near the yellow sun, and he wakes up eyes red because what's her name got killed. Oh, no, she was screaming Wonder Woman,
yes.
And it kind of woke him up, but he has like a 5 o'clock shadow, and right then and there, I became a Superman fan again, because the way Jim Lee
You just
does,
need to be reminded sometimes.
Just Jim
shit.
Lee's art style and everything, how he, directs fucking DC to go about, the Justice League and whatnot, I love, but anyway, I like the more rugged Superman, however, I really don't like the really burly Jack Superman. I kind of like a more lean Superman.
I like all three versions.
I don't like him like Jack really muscular.
I like
Christopher
Reeves, who's like
I like
very
Christopher
lean.
Reeve. He's very lean.
The only one I don't like is some people draw him like Bruce Lee sized, where he's like crazy thin but cut to shreds.
I don't want that either.
I think that's too much.
I want him to look
statue.
More like more believable.
I like him in between.
Because that kind of keeps him like more down to earth
like
and more
the,
like one of us.
I like him the Jim Lee cut.
Yeah.
The Jim Lee where he's like, he looks like The Rock now.
I think
how
Jim
the Rock,
Lee really
Dwayne Johnson
hit the nail on the
three.
Head with
The only
Superman.
Problem is I don't want Jim Lee in fucking charge anymore. He's a shitty runner of that company, in my opinion. And I know that's fucking biased because I've really enjoyed a lot of the stuff from the New 52.
He was good for Image. He was good for...
As a whole. No, he's a great artist.
Yeah.
And he can, like, run, but the fact that he has time to write stories and draw.
It just seems like there's too much he's doing.
It's way too much. Yeah. He has no business. You
like, why
shouldn't
you just stick to writing.
You shouldn't.
And
well, I don't think
artist.
He writes. I think he just draws.
A little bit.
I don't think, and I've met him. He's a wonderful guy.
He's amazing.
And the stuff he does that's great is really great. I just wish there was someone at DC
yeah.
that was really in charge of the universe.
Yeah.
And it feels like they never is. It feels like they're always meandering. I really like Future's End, which is a weekly series. I love weekly series. But even that, like, meanders sometimes. For, like, a month, it'll meander. And I'm like, Jesus fucking Christ.
And an artist, like, a great artist that occasionally writes as a runner is okay. I feel like a great writer should be running. Like, I love Scott Snyder. I also really do.
You know what, though? I don't even think you need a great writer.
I don't think he's ready to run, like, a company like DC.
I also don't
He's definitely
think,
a candidate
I
maybe
don't even
10,
think
20 years
a,
from now.
What you need is a great... Well, you need someone who can take great ideas. You need a really great editor.
Yeah.
You need someone who's maybe a good writer but a great storyteller. Like, I would never give the job to Kevin Smith. He'd be way too busy, like, thinking of shit to write. Someone like Ralph Garman. Again, I'm just thinking of outside names, who does a very funny show, Hollywood Babylon, with Kevin Smith. A podcast you're probably definitely listening to if you listen to this fucking piece of shit. But you need someone like John, my brother.
Yeah.
Someone who loves the world and can direct it without being like, well, let me write a couple issues. Like, you shut the fuck up. You got almost 50 books to make sure make some semblance of sense together.
Need someone that gets the big picture.
The fact that when they restarted the DC universe with the new 52, the fact that they were like, all right, Batman's been Batman for 5 years, but he's had three sidekicks. Someone should have been like, flag on the play. The fuck are you talking about? Well, we want Batman to be younger. Oh, great. Don't have other Robins then.
Yeah.
We'll have all this ammunition to, you want to start Batman's been Batman for 5 years. Dick Grayson is Robin. He's 8, and he's been Robin for 1 year. Or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Well, no, because we want Nightwing and we want Barbara. Well, then Batman cannot be 25.
No.
He has to be 35. Or whatever the fuck. There's no one at DC to do that.
Batman needs to be aged appropriately. To have him forever in his late 20s, early 30s, that's a boring Batman to me.
I like mid-30s Batman.
I want 40s Batman. I want
really?
Battle-torn, seeing some shit, going a little loopy.
Yeah.
Getting to certain points when he's battling the Penguin, Riddler, Two-Face, where he almost kills them. He's drawn out. He's so sick of catching them, locking them up, and them getting out again. He's sick of the same old, same old. I want him just drawn out. And now, I want Nightwing in his early 20s, ready to get the cowl.
You know what would be really cool?
Batman can't be Batman forever. That's why he's a mass vigilante.
If someone came to me and they were like, all right, Charlie, we're going to start the newer 49. what's
the
your
newish
pitch?
49.
If you're holding a gun to my head and you're like, we want to restart the universe again, what do you want to do? I would have two types of imprints. I would have the current DCU, and I'd simultaneously be telling stories from 20 years ago. So what I would have is I was like, okay, well, some people want 25-year-old Batman. They're going to get it. That's going to be Detective Comics is going to be 25-year-old Batman. We're going to start. He's been Batman for 5 years. I am also going to tell 45-year-old Batman stories, and that's going to be the Batman imprint. I'm going to have two different chunks of books. Have the stories that take place fucking back in the day and current ones. And my current ones are going to have the 20-something Nightwing. They're going to have Superboy and Steel. Yeah. But if you rewind, it's going to be 5 years into the universe where Superman's been around, so there's the Justice League. This way you could tell cool stories.
Yeah.
Like, if 5 years from now I want to age up Robin in the old school ones, I can say that you can see how Robin became Nightwing.
Yeah.
You can see how the next Robin got the mantle.
Well, it's the thing. Like, they had
too many
books where if they have Superman Action Comics, I feel like there was no line.
They used to be years
separating
apart, but
they
never told. Like, when they first started Action Comics,
it just seems like
Action Comics was supposed to be like 3 years in the future,
right?
Compared to Superman, because Superman told the stories. Yeah. It was supposed to tell like the pre Justice League stories. Superman, you know. And I think they even used it for one of the chapters, but it was like, Superman, learn to fly. You can tell these awesome stories. I might even go really crazy, and if you want to have three Batman books, my universe is going to be split in two. I'm going to have the current stories. I'm going to have 20 years ago stories. I would also, in that, if you want me to have other, stories that don't fit inside of those universes, I would love to do a series and really start with Batman Year Zero and not the miniseries they did that I liked. They did a series called Zero Year.
Yeah.
But I would do a real Batman Zero. Start it when he's 18 and he's leaving Gotham to get trained. Mm. Do it. Do it in real time. Do it that you can tell their, you know, monthly stories or really age with it. So 3 years down the road, we might be done after fucking 36 issues. Maybe after 36 issues, maybe he's finally going back to Gotham.
Mm-hmm.
And I would have writers and artists, and I would have, if I'm in charge of DC, I'm like, this is what we're doing. The first 12 issues, we're going to go from point A to point B. Point A is him leaving Gotham. Point B is he goes to the League of Shadows to get trained.
Mm-hmm.
Year one. Year two, issue 13 through fucking 24. It's him, Ra's al Ghul. We're only telling Batman being trained by Ra's al Ghul stories. The last four issues are going to be him figuring out whether or not he's cool with killing. So he's a member of the League of Shadows.
Yeah.
By the end of that run. The third year, he's betrayed Ra's al Ghul. We're going to do a quick 3-issue run where it's the ramifications of that, and then it's him prepping to go back. So maybe he, like, I borrow shit from the Batman movies that Nolan did. He gets himself locked in the world's most dangerous prison on purpose, but now he's the trained one, because I didn't really like that in Batman Begins. It was like he went in as a dodo bird to get tough. Mm-hmm. He's a fucking ass kicker already. That's the person you need. You need someone that if you're writing detective,
yeah,
and you're like, here's my idea. He's gonna fight Joker. You need someone there to be like, great, great. You can definitely have Joker. You can't have him yet. Because right now he's in Suicide Squad, and those issues are supposed to run similar time frames.
Yeah.
You need someone in charge that's gonna work the puzzle. You can't take a pause to draw right if you're trying to navigate 50
something
books.
It just seems like they're putting like one, hold on, we're gonna put this on pause. And we're gonna jump to this story.
They're literally doing that with Convergence. Yeah. Every book is taking off for a month for a miniseries that maybe not everyone... I want to read it, so I'm cool with it. But it was the fucking problem with Nightwing's run.
But
in
when
the new
things
52.
Start running
in
different
new
books
52,
start running into each other.
Yeah,
that make no sense.
But
like,
one of my
is...
favorite books is Nightwing.
Yeah.
And I loved it, but every fucking 5 issues would have to pause because he'd be involved in a Batman storyline.
Yeah.
So it's like, go fuck yourself. I just want to read about Nightwing. Don't make me read other shit. That's another thing I'm fucking sick of.
Yeah.
I'm sick of reading one comic and like, find out what happens to Captain Xanadu in Xanadu Presents.
I noticed that a lot of the newer books now that I've been picking up is kind of why I took a break from comics for almost a year now. They have the right at the end of the issue. No. I was reading a Marvel comic and it really fucking annoyed me. It says right in like the bottom corner on like the third page as I'm like just started reading, find out who this character is by reading this issue. Really? Or these
and that's an old principle.
Tie-ins have been annoying me lately because they haven't been done right.
Well, the whole thing where they like that used to be an awesome tease, the thing that bugged you. When you would have the last issue
at the last page to be continued.
Or not even.
That was my fucking tease.
Not even. You could have on page 13 that Superman's fighting Brainiac and they're
fighting
the city.
I like that they're now helping
another
people
hero,
figure out how tie-ins
totally,
work.
Totally. Another hero flies in and like catches a person.
Yeah.
And is like, you know, don't worry, Superman, I'll cover it down here. If you want to throw in a bubble that's like, learn more about Steel in DC Presents, Steel number one. Great. Don't make me have to do homework, though.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be like, I've read graphic novels from DC and Marvel.
Yeah.
We're slap in the middle. It's like, find out the conclusion of this battle in volume 6 of Birds of Prey.
Yeah.
Volume 2 of Cyclops. Fuck you.
Yeah, like jumping in between. Like, it should be conclude. Like, the storyline should be concluded in that run.
If you can't sell me a graphic novel that's complete, don't sell me a graphic novel.
Well, that's the thing. Don't say, like, we're going to continue this battle in this issue,
it's
go
horseshit.
Get that. No.
And
the storyline should be finished, but the explanation of like characters, like find out more about this character in this origin book or whatever the fuck they're
it's
in their main book that made like they made a slight cameo.
It's something that they used to be able to do well. Whereas like if the Justice League was fighting,
they
a
want
major
you
threat,
buying more, they want you
I
reading
understand
more.
That, but they can get it without forcing me because, for example, a few years ago, DC did a big event. The whole JLA was fighting. And in each of the JLA members' books, it was the same story. or Death of Superman.
Yeah.
Death of Superman carried through all the books without being a necessity for the story. Because it was like, well, this is what Batman, how Batman's dealing with it. A true tie-in is like, do you want more? Well, you can get more over here. You don't need it.
Yeah.
But you can
get
more.
That's the thing. Like, they're starting to, like, you need this, so you have to go get that book. Like, no, it's not. I want a tie-in that's not a necessity. Like, I remember you telling me, oh, hey, you're reading that? You should get this tie-in. That's the only way I could figure out tie-ins with
that's
someone that read more comics and knew it was word of mouth. Now they're forcing me. Like, with Civil War, they did Civil War really well. It was, you had the main story of Civil War. Everyone led up to this big fucking event, and you were on this side or you were on this side, A or B, for or against. But then there were standalone books like Civil War Spider-Man, Civil War X-Men, Civil War Iron Man, Civil War fucking Captain America. Those were all about that character or that group leading up to Civil War. I didn't have to read a single one.
Hell no.
I just picked up Civil War by itself. I knew Captain America's pissed because, however, the Captain America, the Civil War Captain America book by itself, it was like whatever, a mini, so it was like four issues. It went to more depth why he was pissed off and why he was doing this. But I didn't necessarily have to read it. They just, in that graphic, that fucking huge graphic novel, they just said, Captain America's pissed because of this. Done.
Yeah.
But they explained in the
or
other one.
If you
I didn't
go
have
back
to read
and
it.
That you could, and again, that is a great way to do it. There was a time.
But now
where
it's just jumping.
There was a time where it was even better. Like, from probably just a year or so before Civil War, where it used to be Captain America would fucking, like, walk through a broken glass, and fucking Spider-Man would turn and be like, well, you certainly handed Carnage his ass, and him like wiping off the shit. They used to not even need a bubble because it was just like, that's why he scratched up.
Yeah.
He fought Carnage, stupid. But it didn't need to be an editor's note. It was another character being like, you certainly handled him, Captain. Ridiculous. Hey, DC, Marvel, we're for hire. Let me run that shit. New 49, brought to you by 6 and
New
60.
37. New 30 in a row?
Nooch. Oh, man. Would you ever call the cops on Jen?
Depends.
What if Jen started, like, beating the shit out of you?
Yeah, I would. I have no qualms about it. I'd do it.
You're like, equal rights, equal pay.
Yeah, totally. Why are you so bossy? Yeah.
In Alliance, Ohio, a 39-year-old dialed emergency services on Wednesday evening because his wife stole his cocaine.
Well, okay.
Yup. Me and my lady is having a misunderstanding and shit about something I bought.
Wait, that's what. Oh, is he white or black?
White.
Really? He looks like, what was his name?
He looks like a cokehead.
No, he looks like what, that died a long time. He was in Edward Scissorhands. It's one of his last movies.
You have a phone.
I know, but I wanted to be smart and think of it myself. God damn you, technology.
Me and my lady's having a misunderstanding about something I bought, he said. I bought some cocaine earlier, and she wanted to take my cocaine.
I feel like that's not something you report to the police.
Conversation drifts from the line and into presumably the living room, where Colin spouts off a few fucks and shits as the 911 operator waits patiently. It was only around 2:55, the 2 minute and 55 second mark, that the caller returned to the line and realized who he'd called in the first place. He laughed and then wrote off the situation as if his life had temporarily found itself in a grittier Curb Your Enthusiasm episode. It don't matter, he told the operator. I guess, man.
He looks like a dirtbag Vincent Price.
He does look like a dirtbag Vincent Price.
Man.
Unfortunately, authorities didn't feel the same way. A squad car arrived at the residence and arrested Collins for drug possession. The police report obtained by the Smoking Gun claims that Collins had a pipe, used to smoke marijuana in his possession. He was arrested and charged with the misuse of 911 and drug paraphernalia. Collins was taken to county jail, a place where several jagoffs have become familiar on an account of bonehead calls 911. If you need an example, there was one guy in Georgia who got pissed over getting the wrong McDonald's order in a drive-thru and called 911 about it.
Wait.
That's right. They forgot it. Like, they didn't supersize his meal.
I'm sorry, but, like, 911 is something, like, I feel like you don't, like, you know not to fuck with. My brother accidentally hit 911, and I don't even think it rang. He hung up. They called back.
Yeah.
You know, like,
they're
this
911.
This is something, like, you don't fuck with it, you know? And the sad thing is, did you know it's actually not against the law to make a false police report, depending on what you report?
That can't be true.
It's true. I swear to God.
What do you mean?
I went through this whole thing where this person filed a police report over something that never happened, and the cop knew it, and I knew it, and I asked him, and he's like, yeah, not against the law. Might be a state-by-state thing, but apparently it's not, and depending on what they report, yeah. Sometimes it's not a false police report. Fucking weird.
That's crazy.
Isn't it? It's nuts. But what did he say to her? Like, I'm going to call the cops. You stole my cocaine. What would be her response? Okay. See how far you get with that fucking allegation. Even if she did, what are the cops going to say? Give him back his cocaine. Okay. Now we can arrest him for fucking possession of cocaine.
Here's my problem. I feel like that's not an inappropriate phone call. He bought something and she stole it. It happened to be illegal.
But it's illegal.
But she's still a thief.
It's illegal. But it's legal for... I feel like they both should be arrested. Her for stealing him. Her for robbing him. And him for owning something that's illegal. Like, that's not...
Can you own something that's illegal? Or do you just have something that's illegal?
Well, if you paid for it through goods and services. Blow a man for some cocaine. That's the services part. I'm talking to you, Danny.
It's a for the record, a false police report is not constitutionally protected, which is why it's different in different states.
Got it. See? All right, so I was half right.
I'm not touching all right. That shit in New York.
No. Mm-mm.
Gerard Nolan has too little of a dick to podcast. I'm calling 911 right now.
I'll call 911 right now.
911?
911. I'm going to call 911.
911. 911 sounds like a cool cop spinoff. Cops, 9-1-1.
Oh my God, that would work. It just shows all guys. Yeah. Ever notice that on Cops?
No, it's a contest show where you take all the criminals who ran from the cops and they all compete against each other. Cops, 9-1-1.
But you got to play that music in the background. That, what the fuck was that?
Old bad boys, bad
no,
boys.
No. Dun, 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 dun. That old, like, running,
the
like.
Olympic
thing. Yes.
Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. The worst part was we were both running.
It's like
running.
An 80s montage of all cops. But it's cops running side by side. It actually turned off because the phone's dying. We're talking about something. Don't you pay attention to that. But it's actually just showing cops running side by side. And then they're handing... No! It's cops... And when you run in that, like, circle, I get, what is it, fucking, like, running track? You have to hand the little fucking, pass the little fucking dildo, whatever the fuck they're handing each
baton.
Other. Yes, thank you. But it's cop, criminal. So it's...
A bonding exercise.
It's a bonding exercise. You
At
know,
the end, cop gets to kill someone.
Yeah.
The loser.
The black one. So fuck it. What the fuck, man? That's a lot going on now in the news. Have you noticed
well,
that?
Well, did you see the statistics, though?
No, I didn't see that.
Statistically, more cops killed white people this year than black.
Yeah, well, I believe that. Dirty, dirty white people, man.
Awful.
It's the fucking media. What do you
want
from
it? We're not going to half start this topic.
No.
Not today. Mm-mm. I need a stronger drink than a beer.
Yeah, you need like fucking scotch on the rocks.
No rocks.
No
scotch
rock.
Out of a bottle.
No. Not ice. Like actual rocks.
Yes.
Like pebbles.
Like I'm swallowing these pebbles. They make it hurt less. You guys made it. You made it through another hour of me and Gerard ranting and raving. Guys, the website is 660.net, and it has links to everything else. Hit us up, rate, comment, subscribe. Most importantly, go out there and try to do something special for someone today. Guys, again, Charlie Rivera, Drunken Monkey Studio, 660.net. Our sponsors, ReadUSComics.com and Atomic Comics, the comic book store. I don't think they have a website. I think they just have their Facebook page, facebook.com/AtomicsComics, maybe? I don't know. I'm sure the link is on the website, 660.net. This is, I know it's no doubt, but it is Open the Gate, available on iTunes. Peace out, sucker butts. We'll see you next week.
Again.